Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. And I'm just making myself some blue and white for the sky. And we'll get this painting going straight away because I'm excited. I really want to get the paint down. So I've got a few colours. Yellow ochre, alizarin crimson, ultramarine blue, sap green, burnt umber, and then of course we have our titanium white. We've got a house, but we need to put in a bit of sky. There's a bit of sky showing here, so we need to put that in first. I just grabbed a bit more blue then, just using this page, which is a scrapbook that you can get. You can get scrapbooks and you can use them to paint on. They work quite well actually. I've been using them for watercolours and acrylics, and then, I mean watercolours and gouache, and then since I started getting into my acrylic paints again, I thought, oh well, they work similar to them, so I'll use that. I want that to be fairly blue, and we're not going to see all of it, only some areas are going to show through. So we get that in, that sky, and then there's some trees. So I want like a dark, so brown and green and blue. Maybe a bit of red as well. Dark, and I'm going to start putting in the trees that are in the background. I'm just bulking up my paint a little bit. Start putting that in, looking at the shapes of the trees. And this is just the dark bit anyway. We can put the light on the top. Something like this. Just sort of pushing my brush up a little bit there, just to get a bit more of that shape. Of course, you can always tap if you want, tap in little areas, or like I just did. Sometimes if you just push the brush up, works quite well. Whatever effect that you want to make. Something like that. Now with the dirty brush, I'm going to get some yellow ochre into that paint. A bit more sap green in it. Get a bit of a different colour, more of a highlighting colour. I can put some of that on. Just where you see some light areas, you put them in. Thank you. Something like that. You can actually see. Let's have a liner brush. Looking for one of these. This one's a better one. It's a bit finer. Number two. It's a rigger brush, actually. A rigger. This brush is a De La Rowney one, a Riga Aquafine. It's mainly for watercolours, to be honest, but they all work the same, don't they? Just getting myself a little bit of white and the brown, a bit of brown and blue. Because I can see a little bit of a tree trunk there. I can see a bit of one there as well. Might as well paint it in. Give that a little bit of detail. There's nothing quite like a little bit of detail sometimes. So the next thing we need to do is we want a little bit of white. Move white over here. A little bit of this sap green. A bit like a greeny white. Probably about that actually, that looks alright. Bit of sap green. There is a little bit of the dirty colours in it. But that's quite good, that's what I wanted. Now I'm going to start putting this house. There's a house that goes there. Something like that. Let's put in this. Just gonna get that roof. So that one goes down to about there. And then there's a chimney that goes about there, I think, about there. Pretty good, pretty close, and then there's some of the building there, and then there's the roof. You can see all of this bit. We'll get in what we can see, and then we can start filling in some of the details. So just sort of looking, at the roof again. Doesn't look quite right to me. I think it's probably like that. I think that's a bit closer anyway. We'll have that like that. There's a bit more. Like a really light version of the colour on the side here. On the side of the chimney. Now I want to get a dark. What I'll go for is a nice dark bluey brown colour. Bit of ultramarine blue, bit of brown. Make almost a black using those two. It's got a piece that goes across like this, and then that goes there. And then as this dries, I'll be able to put that colour on a bit better. It's not really going on because it's still a bit wet. Yeah, wait for that to dry a bit. So I'll do another bit of the other area while I'm waiting. I'll just spray my paints quickly. Just get myself a dark. It's quite dark around this bit here. Goes to about there. I'll just throw in some blue and green in there. And around this side, there's stuff growing all along here. There's a bit of a gap there where you can see grass along there. This has grown over quite a lot here, and there's a nice warm roof. See if we can do that roof. It's sort of a greyish colour. Maybe not quite as warm as I thought. Bit more blue in it. I think that's not bad actually. That roof goes about there. goes to about there. You don't see a lot of it, so it's a lot lighter than what I've done. It's a bit more white on it. A bit more of that dark colour. Stick it along here. It's dried enough for it to go on now. Got the indication of a roof there. That white that I put in, it's more at an angle. There to be too much. Now there's some windows. I need to put in the windows. There's one about there. They are pretty cool shapes. Shapes in. And there's a window here as well, a smaller one. This window you can't see because there's a bush there. This one you can. While we're at it, might as well sort this chimney out. Put some chimney pots on. little bit of dark. Anyway, they're really small, so I won't worry too much about them. Right, let's do the dark part of the window now. Just grabbing a little bit of blue and brown. And in this one as well. And there is a little bit of a shadow as well that goes up down here. So we could put that in as well, might as well. Probably should have painted them first. Anyway, we can paint that over the top. Some dark on this part of the window as well. Marks there as well. Okay, now I need a nice bright green in here because there's a nice slip of green. Probably like a yellow ochre and a sap green maybe. Tiny bit of white as well. Might work. So I want this green that goes. Okay, and then there's a lot of colour, dark colour in front. Blue and green and brown. Put more together. I can see some of that. This is all sort of dark here. And then there's some light. So I want a reddish, yellowish colour. Sort of a bit of brown in it, maybe. And that's for the path. It sort of comes, sweeps around here, down this hill, but it's got some light on it. Some of this green up here as well. Some of it there. I think we need a brighter yellow, so I might get a cadmium yellow out just to brighten it, because it's a bit too dull there. We want a little bit more of a change of colour here, and this undergrowth stuff. Dark in it even there as well. Some dark, and then it goes into a light. Now I need to think about where the light's hitting. Just need to dull that path a little bit. Okay. So now this point, I need to get some brighter yellow because I'm finding my yellow ochre is not quite there. Okay, I grabbed some yellow, some cadmium yellow, so I can use that in a bit. I just want to get the dark of this tree up here first. Here as well. Just want to re-darken this as well. Okay, so that's a bit better. I'm getting the overall feel of the place a bit better. So I've got the light. The light coming in here. Cadmium yellow and the sap green. It does work perfect for that sort of thing, doesn't it? Get that light going. You could even put a little bit of red in it. Cadmium yellow, sap green, a bit of red in it. So I've got the light coming this way, so I've got some light hitting this. Might use a bit more yellow just to that really sparkles it a bit now, and then a bit more green up here. Throw in some yellow ochre as well. Couple of breaks in that colour. And then I want to brighten up this path as well. And of course, we're dancing all over the painting now, but I want light on this side. This tree, so I can get a few leaves and things. I'm just tapping the brush really and thinking about where I would want more light to be. Maybe there's a bit of light breaking in here, and some of these here and there. A little bit of something there. you can go light and dark to create a bit more distance in your painting as well. So you've got like this dark, you've got like a dark, a light, a lighter, a dark, and then a light again. And it's a good way of creating a lot of depth in your painting. Can make this a bit more obvious that it's a few things growing there. And then the path needs a bit more to it, a bit more light in it, more sunshine, a bit of yellow. Let's have it there, let's have it come around there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Quite like that. I might even throw a little bit. Kind of like the idea of a bit of a bit more light in the sky or something. Okay, bit of a cloud, like this. Yeah, that worked quite well. So, just have a look at the painting, see if we want to add anything or change anything. Kind of like the idea of a couple of little birds maybe in the sky. It's a nice little scene, really. It's quite a. It's come out better than I thought. You know, you get these ideas and you wonder how they'll look as a painting. Sometimes they work out alright. I'm quite happy with this one. Just need a bit more dark there. Go maybe a little bit of using the liner, maybe a few like little grassy bits here, using a bit of yellow ochre and white. Couple of bits there as well. Get a few different types of brush strokes that way as well, a variety of brush strokes. So I think I'll call that one. Just about done. I'm just gonna just use the liner just to dot in a few lighter bits on that tree. Yeah, I quite like that. Nice little scene, somewhere where you could walk up to the house. So I'll call that one finished. Thanks very much for watching this one, and I'll see you at another one. Cheers, bye.